Should governments promote happiness? After all, governments promote economic growth, and economic growth did increase. But reported happiness did not. If we are getting richer, why are we not happier? The wellbeing program at LSE shows that we continuously aspire to improve our lifestyle, and we compare our success with that of our peers. Therefore, competition to be more successful means pursuing more money, requiring a faster lifestyle, leading to more stress. So though GDP is higher, so are depression and mental ill health, alcoholism and drug addictions, and broken families. Professor Lord Richard Layard, director of the Wellbeing Program at the Center for Economic Performance, worked with the UK government and the O'Donnell Commission to make well-being a goal of UK public policy. The Wellbeing Program's research reveals that subjective well-being depends on work, finances, the quality of relationships, and most importantly, physical and mental health. Furthermore, subjective well-being survey answers are well correlated with brain activity and stress levels. The Wellbeing Program also advises international forums to make happiness a key goal in the international agenda. So how can public policy be used to promote well-being? The Wellbeing Program identifies key issues policy can address, including mental health, life skills, and vocational training. As you can see, mental illness can affect a large population size. But the treatment of mental illness is less than other diseases in the UK. Professor Layard argues that the under-treatment of people with mental ill health is sheer discrimination and an abuse of human rights. He calculates that the net cost of improving access to psychological therapies would be zero, as costs of therapies are low and the recovery rates of patients are high, thereby reducing long-term medical costs and welfare payments of patients to create net benefits. The impact of the Wellbeing Program's research has increased over time. In 2008, the NHS improved access to psychological therapies, and by 2010, extended the program to children. By 2013, 400,000 people were treated a year, with 45% recovery rates. Professor Layard advocates for a policy goal to have this program reach 25% of adults and 33% of children by 2020. However, the Wellbeing Program's research also focuses on UK youth unemployment. 13% of 16 to 24-year-olds are not in education, training, or employment, thereby contributing to the low skills level of the bottom 40% of the UK population. The Wellbeing Program argues for governments to guarantee apprenticeships to increase their skills level. So, the Wellbeing Program has demonstrated how public policy can help specific groups increase their well-being, to become engaged citizens, and build a happy society.